Hello all you scavengers, I'm King Link and this is the last look and review of 7 Days to Die. Before we begin, I'd like to say if you enjoy this or want to see more, consider subscribing. I don't ask for money or anything, I just would appreciate a subscription, a view, a like, or anything else. Thank you for your consideration. I'm working my way up to 100 subscribers to get the URL from YouTube, so I appreciate any step on that way. So, let's begin. Now, this is an early access game, but it's also the final game of the early unlocks from Humble Monthly Bundle for November 2018. We've already looked at Hollow Knight and Hitman, now we come to 7 Days to Die. I don't typically review early access games. I don't like survival horror, and I don't like scavenging. So really, I have to be honest, this is not the type of game I want to be reviewing. But since it is in the Humble Monthly Bundle, I think the early access should be somewhat ignored. They're releasing it as a game they want to feature, so I'm going to take it as that. At the same time, I do review games outside my comfort zone, and I'll be objective here. However, I'll be honest, this is going to be harsh. You know, I have to say something about the early access piece. This game hasn't been updated in a year. Currently, it is October 27th. The game was last updated on October 26th. Sounds recent, but it's actually in 2017. That's a whole year ago. They're working on a new patch, but it's when it's done. Personally, I don't like that scenario for early access games. And the fact is, I have to take the game that I can see here. Now, you see, beyond that, I fundamentally don't like 7 Days to Die's gameplay. But I have a lot more issues with its implementation of the game. Its interest, its graphics, its promises, and the fact that, honestly, it just stinks. So I have to get into that. Now, I'm playing the game that I've already started. Honestly, I'm early in the game, and I'm just trying to forge something interesting. Will I find something? Well, my guess was no when I wrote this, and the end result is also kind of no. However, check the screen. You're going to see the graphics of the base, and they're a bit weak. Even understanding the 5-year development cycle here and evaluating them based on 2013 standards, they're still quite weak. I'm not a graphics snob, but there's not even a style to the graphics. It's just assets thrown together, and they're low polygon and more. Now, this is likely done to allow huge draw distance and multiple buildings to be seen. That could work, but there's not much interesting on the screen, even when you make a huge when you're on a huge hill. You can see a building in the distance and go there, but it doesn't make the drab graphics acceptable. In addition, in the past, I've knocked over trees, and the rendering on the bottom of them are awful. It's actually an empty tube. I'm sorry, but being able to see through a tree kind of sucks. The only good part here in the game is that the zombies in the zombie game looks good, and there's actually a lot of variety in them. Too bad everything else in the game is rather weak. The pre-designed buildings do look good, like the fort that I started in, but they always should. There's no question about that. Everything else, though, is not as nice. The story here, too, is a bit of a problem. I know scavenging games shouldn't get dinged for no story, and I would agree with that if I did not see that it was one of the goals on the Kickstarter. They wanted a dynamic story. The Fun Pimps, which is a cringeworthy name of a company, promised a dynamic and interesting story through notes and stuff. There's small dynamic quests here, and there are small notes, but the story is nowhere actually to be found. You do get a quest to teach you pieces of the game, and a quest to find a traitor, and that's the end of the story. You get to the traitor, and he says nothing else. There's other dynamic pieces, but nothing I really wanted to play. Mostly, the one that I did find was kill a specific type of zombie that I couldn't find, so what was the point? Now, let's talk about the gameplay, and I'm going to gloss over a bunch of this. Check the written review if you really want to hear everything about the game, but the fact is, it's not a very exciting game. What you see me doing here is most of the game. You run around, you scavenge goods, you collect enough, and you're supposed to build a fort to defend. The idea of the name is that every 7 in-game days, a giant horde comes to kill you. Okay, that sounds cool, but that 7 days, though, takes about 7 hours of gameplay. That's a long time, to be honest, and honestly, I got bored after 2. The scavenging is the problem for me. It's not that interesting. Unless I could find a gun, which is unlikely, there's not much out there I wanted. You could build things, but you have to scavenge a lot of rare resources or farm them from places. It's a dull process, and while other games like Minecraft do the same, the difference is the effort in Minecraft to find something you want is mostly about being in the right biome, location, or depth of mind. You know where you can find stuff. Here, you just have to hope to find items that can be searched, search them, and randomly decide what you might find. Kudos if you get something good, but it's not really for me. You need to, of course, build a base to keep safe after those 7 days, but you also need to survive the boredom of the 7 hours. That's a long time, and like I said, I'm honest about this, I didn't last more than 2 hours in any game. I did play 3 games as well as playing online. In fact, when I jumped online to see what the Blood Moon Horde looked like, that's what comes after the 7 days, I found only 2 zombies attacking me. That could be because I was online, or it was a weak horde, or something else, but I will say I didn't find it interesting enough to want to see another one. The real problem is the horde feels like the reason to play this game. You scavenge, you gather items, okay, but really it's not a lot of difficult gameplay or reason to play except that big horde that's supposed to come. But it happens so infrequently, I don't see the point. I do know that every night there's a smaller horde apparently that does show up, but they seem to be quite dumb and I don't even see them as a horde, just random zombies walking. You just crouch and they seem to ignore you. The thing is, after 5 years of being in early access, there should be something fun here. Everything in this game feels a bit weak. The combat isn't interesting and it's a little bit difficult. Foraging for food, which is what you need to heal, or water, is hard, especially after they dropped the spawn rate for it about a year ago, a little bit more than a year. There's not many places to scavenge, and you have to go a long distance to find something to scavenge. And even there, it's not that interesting of an experience for me to walk through a hospital and hope to find something. If you love zombies, there are good zombie games out there, like Resident Evil and others. This isn't one of them, though. If you like building, Minecraft, Terraria, and even Staxels, which I didn't like, is better than this. If you want to play a similar game, I think you could probably find something in DayZ or one of the many other survival games. I'm sure something can do it right for you. But the thing is here, there's nothing that made me want to play more than a couple hours. I wrote more, and like I said, but honestly, I've said what's important. 7 days to die bores me so much that I really don't feel like saying that much more. If this looks fun to you, definitely give it a try. You can grab it in the Humble Bundle for this month, but I really don't think it's interesting at all, and it really doesn't feel like interesting after I've played it. I give 7 days to die a 1.5 out of 5. Yeah, this genre isn't my favorite, but it's the game that earned the score, not the genre. You can go scavenge in other games, you can go hunt and loot items in other games. The problem here is that it's so hard and so infrequent that you find something worthwhile that it's not much fun. I played 6 hours of this game total, and I really can't imagine playing more outside of recording this video. Now, that's 7 days to die. For the Humble Bundle in total, look at the other games, Hollow Knight, Hitman, there's going to be more games. Don't see this as me putting down the Humble Bundle, but 7 Days to Die, I'm sorry, I just can't recommend this game at all, and I think it's even below that. That's all I really have to say. I did put out some first looks a long time ago, I am going to go back to them. Next up, it's a game that I played based on just the image I saw on Steam Big Picture Mode. That's Action Hank, with an E in the Hank. I don't know. So, it's an odd runner game where you play as action figures. Kind of crazy. I've been mixed on it. I'll get into that next time. Until then, I am King Link, and thank you very much for watching.